Welcome to the next lecture, which is there on amplitude modulations, transmitted power and AM efficiency in communications. So we'll understand this transmitted power and AM efficiencies in communication by some examples here. Okay. So these are the learning outcomes. At end of the session, students will be able to illustrate the power and efficiency of an amplitude modulation in communication system here. So just recall, what do you mean by amplitude modulation, frequency modulation and phase modulation here? And just recall how much power is required to transmit and total AM signal here and how much bandwidth is required here. So as we know that the total power required to transmit an AM signal is PT is equals to PC plus PLSB PUSB and bandwidth is 2 FM here. Okay. So now we'll see some examples regarding to the amplitude modulations. So in the main equation of an amplitude modulation, we have seen the three components, that is the carrier signal as well as the LSB and USB. So depending on that only, just we'll solve some examples on this. So this is one example, that is prove that in an AM, the maximum average power transmitted by AM is 1.5 times of the carrier power here. Okay. So what we have to prove, that is the maximum average power, transmitted by AM is 1.5 times of an carrier power here. Okay. So total power required to transmit of an AM signal, that is total power transmitted by the AM signal, is PC plus PLSB plus PUSB. Okay. So these are the three components are there here. Okay. So individually, we have to solve for how much power is required to transmit an carrier signal, LSB and USB here. Okay. But by solving all this, so we know that that is PT is equals to PC bracket 1 plus M square by 2. So this is the total power required to transmit an AM signal here, PC 1 plus M square by 2 here. Okay. So when it will be the maximum power? So as we know that the modulation index M, which lies 0 to 1 here. So at 0, it will be lowest power required and 1 will be the maximum power will required. So M equals to 1 will be the maximum power will be required. So substituting the value of an M in this equation, that is PC 1 plus M square by 2 here. So if you solve this, that is PC 1 plus 1 upon 2. Okay. So it will be PC into 1.5. That is nothing but PT equals to, therefore PT equals to 1.5 PC here. So this is the total power will be 1.5 into PC here. So that is the maximum average power transmitted by AM will be 1.5 times of an carrier power here total. If you substitute the value of an M equals to 1 in this equation, that is 1 plus M square by 2 in that, so you will get the answer, that is PC 1.5. Okay. So now we will understand one more problem, that is based on the antenna current here. So the antenna current of an AM broadcaster, okay, broadcast transmitter modulated to the depth of 40% here. So it is modulated to how much? That is the modulated to M equals to 40%, means it will be 0.4 by an audio sine wave is 11 amperes here. So what is this 11 ampere? It is an the total current or IC current, that is the power carrier current. So antenna current of an AM broadcast transmitter, so it will be an total, so it will be IT equals to 11 amperes here. Okay. Now second statement is what? It increases to 12 amperes as a result of a simultaneous modulation by another audio sine wave. Okay. So whenever there is an 11 ampere, it increases to the 12 amperes when simultaneous modulation by another sine wave. So one more modulating signal is there. If you make use of that signal, so it will be increased to the 12 amperes here. So at that time, IT will be 12 amperes here. Okay, find the modulation index due to this second sine wave, not to the first. So try to understand this. So this is modulation index due to this second sine wave here. So we'll see. So in this example, so when there will be more than one sine wave, so how modulation index is calculated for a multiple sine wave here. So before that, first we have to solve for the IC, because we required for the second equation here. Okay, so we know that formula from the previous lecture, that is IT square is equals to IC square bracket 1 plus M square by 2. That is IT, total current equals to IC current into 1 plus M square by 2. It is in the form of an modulation index in the form of current here. Okay, so when this will be the case 1. Okay, this will be the case 1. So when M equals to 40%, so it will be 0.4, and IT is equals to will be an 11 amperes here. Okay, so if you solve this, so that is IC equals to IT under root, it will be 1 plus M square by 2. Now substituting these values, that is M and IT, into this equation, so it will be IC equals to 11 upon under root 1 plus 0.4 square upon 2, so which gives 10.58 amperes. So this is total IC current, that is the power carrier current, that is IC equals to 10.58 amperes here. Okay, so now in the case 2, what is there? So your case 2 is what? It increases to, IT increases to 12 amperes. Now we have to find out the modulation index here, that is the M2 here. So if you donate this M1, so what will be the your M2 here? Okay, so we know that relation, that is power is directly proportional to I square. So that's why we have to take this equation. Okay, that is the IT square is equals to IC square plus 1 plus M square. It is same like an PT is equals to PC 1 plus M square by 2, because power is directly proportional to the I square here. Okay, so now if you solve for case 2, that is the IT when increases to 12 amperes, and M2 will be what? Okay, so before that, so we have to solve for the modulation index M here. So it will be same like IC equals to IT under root 1 plus M square by 2. Okay, so we know that IC, from this IC will be 10.58, okay, 10.58, and IT will be 12 under root 1 plus M square by 2. Okay, so we'll solve here now. Okay, after that it will be 12 upon 58 equals to 1 plus M square by 2. So after solving this, M comes to be an 0.75. okay, so this M comes to be an 75. Okay, now if you have the multiple sine wave, if you have an multiple sine wave, so at that time you are going to solve for this M square is equals to M1 square plus M2 square here. Okay, so total modulation index M, okay, so this will be M of T, so it will be M1 square plus M2 square here now. Okay, so now we have to solve for the M2 here. Find the modulation index due to the second sine wave. So we have solved for the M here, okay, that is we have taken as an M2 here. Okay, so it will be substituting the values in this equation, that is M2 square is equals to MT minus M1 square here. This is MT. Now if you donate this, so it will be 0.75 square minus 0.4 square, so it comes to be 0.64 here. M2 will comes to be 0.64 here. So if you have a multiple sine wave, so we have to make use of this formula, M total T, that is modulation, total modulation will be of M1 square plus M2 square plus, like this will be MN square here. Okay. Okay, this will be the modulation index here. Okay, so there is one more problem. If you solve for that, so determine the efficiency and percentage of total power carried by the side bands of an AM wave for the modulation index M equals to 1.5 and 0.3. So we'll see the efficiency and percentage of total power carried by the side bands here. Okay, so how power efficiency is calculated? So we know that by using the formula, that is M square by 2 plus M square. Okay, so now for the case 1, if you see M equals to 1 here by putting here, so it will be 1 upon 1 plus 2, so 1 by 3, so it will be 33%. Okay, for case 2, for M equals to 0.5, so if you substitute this 0.5 square upon 2 plus 0.5 square, so it comes to be an 0.11, that will be 11.11% here. Okay, so for case 3, if you see M equals to 0.3 square upon 2 plus 0.3, so which comes to be 0.43, so which comes to be 4.3% here. Okay, so what we have to analyze, so we have calculated the efficiency. Now the percentage of total power carried by the sideband. So how much will be the sideband power will be carried? Here it will be 67%. So here the sideband will carry how much? That is 88.89% here. So here the total power carried by the sidebands of the wave, that is the carrier power will be 95.7 here. Okay, so this is the carrier power will be there. So this is the 11.11%, so it will be an 88.89 here. So this is the determination of an efficiency and the percentage of total power carried by the sideband here. Okay, so this will be the carrier signal. Okay, so this will be an carrier side. Okay, so we'll complete the lecture here. Okay, thank you. Thank you.